It's the pre-weigh-in psychological breakdown.
Hey guys, and welcome back. It's Saturday of week 48, man, which means it's time for that pre-weigh-in psychological breakdown. Let's jump into it. Thanks for tuning back in, guys. So here we are, coming to the end of week 48, man, as I try to get my mind right for tomorrow's weigh-in, as well as the next 2 weeks of business travel, man, which, you know, has a way of throwing a fucking wrench into the whole plan, man. But all in all, week 48, I feel like has been pretty good, especially from a workout standpoint, man. As you guys know, I work out 6 days a week, Sunday through Friday, and I lift, moderately heavy on those days, right, across all of my workouts. So, that's been really good. I feel like my body is sore. It's rebuilding. It's repairing the muscle like it should. And I'm getting stronger, man. I can definitely tell I'm getting stronger. And everything seems to be going really well with those things. But the one unintended side effect of that, as most of you may know, is that my body is asking for more calories, right? Because it's doing more work, right? And it asks for those calories in the form of increased hunger, which is always the hardest part of any diet, right? Is getting past that hunger phase, right? Well, it's starting to reintroduce in me because of the amount of work I'm doing with my body. So, I'm not really able. I'm finding it more difficult over the last couple weeks to keep to my 1,000 calorie deficit that my Fitness Pal is telling me to keep to, right? So, in other words, my Fitness Pal thinks I should eat about 1,600 calories a day to maintain a 1,000 calorie deficit. So, it thinks that my TDEE is 2,600 calories a day. What I'm finding is that I'm keeping about a 700 calorie deficit a day, and that's average, right? Some days I keep a 900 calorie deficit, some days I keep a 500 calorie deficit. Either way, it doesn't really matter. I'm keeping about a 700 calorie deficit in the strictest sense of the word with my Fitness Pal. Now, that does not incorporate any calories that I'm burning through workout. And mostly, the reason I'm doing that mostly is because I'm kind of using this guy, this smartwatch, to track all of that. And I don't really know how accurate it is with calorie counts. So I'm assuming that it's not accurate at all, right? So I'm not trying to compensate with those calories, right? So I'm probably not maintaining a 1,000 calorie deficit a day, right? So I don't really know what to expect out of tomorrow's weigh-in, right? Because the last 2 weeks were real easy, right? Week 46 to Vegas, super high, and we knew that was going to happen. Last week, week 47, was the week back from Vegas. We knew I was going to shed most of that water weight, and that happened, right? As predicted, right? But this week, that's not the case, and I don't really have any idea what to expect out of the scale tomorrow, right? But whatever it is, it is, man, and I'm cool with that, right? What I'm really kind of concerned about is the next 2 weeks of travel, right? Going to a site I've never been to, don't know what the food options are around there, and it makes me worried for the short-term progress of this diet, right? But while I'm concerned about that, right, I don't really like work travel from a dietary standpoint. I do think it's good to introduce myself to new situations, right, where I have to be a little more malleable, right, a little more flexible in my diet, right, while still trying to maintain a deficit and lose weight, right, and that's a challenge in the short term for sure. Like, a lot of people really like a lot of routine, and I'm one of them that likes a lot of routine when it comes to dieting, right, because it makes dieting easy, it makes it autopilot, right, but the problem with that is if you get into that too early and you stay on that too long, then once you lose all the weight and you get into maintenance, you don't really have any idea how to deal with the challenges, right, that life throws at you, and you might gain some of that weight back, if not all of it. So in the long term, this type of travel is pretty good for me mentally, because it forces me to try and be flexible with the way I do things, which is going to probably be more analogous to the way it's going to be once I'm in maintenance, right? So honestly, it's probably a good thing. Short term, bad. Long term, good, right? But, you know, it is what it is, man. So I have to deal with it. And uh, uh, I, I, I think it'll be fine, man, because if you guys remember, the first part of this year, right, back in January, February, March, April, all that, I traveled a lot, and I still managed to lose weight, right? But it took me a little bit to figure it out, but I still managed to lose weight. So we'll see what the next 2 weeks brings, man, but more importantly, I'm trying to figure out how tomorrow's gonna go, dude, and simply, I don't have any freaking idea, man. We're gonna find out tomorrow. I'm gonna find out, along with the rest of you guys, how it goes tomorrow, right? I don't have a great feeling about it. I don't have a bad feeling about it. It is what it is, man. I definitely have an increased hunger due to working out a lot more, gaining strength, which is incredibly important to me because I don't just want to lose weight and not have any health or fitness behind it, right? I don't want to. I need to do this and still be fit and still have a good muscle structure and everything else. I don't want to lose all that. So it is important to me to do this while working out. It's just that I have noticed over the last couple weeks that my body is reacting differently now to the workouts because I feel like they're going better. I feel like the body is really responding to it. But in return, the body wants more calories, man. It's like, hey, guy, if you're going to do those workouts, awesome. We're going to give you what you're asking for, but you got to give us something in return. And I'm trying to do that in a very healthy way that will also allow me to stick to a deficit and lose weight. But we'll see if that works, man. Hell, tomorrow I might get on the scale. I might be up. Who the hell knows what's going to happen? But we'll see, man. Anyway, guys, trying to keep this one short. I got a lot of shit to do for the next 2 weeks, travel. That's pretty much it for today, guys. Like and subscribe. Leave me some comments. Let me know what's going on with you guys and if you've experienced anything like this. And, of course, you know, I'm hoping that you'll tune in tomorrow for week 48's weigh-in. But until then, as always, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you later. Bye.